Hey guys, today we're going to deploy a static site to Cloudflare. Now, typically when I build these projects, I deploy to Vercel and they have a great user experience and it's very easy to deploy sites on Vercel, but it's probably best to not keep all your eggs in one basket. And I was interested to try out Cloudflare. So I'm going to walk through exporting this site, which is just a template that I downloaded, and I'm going to deploy it to Cloudflare. And I thought that I would record the process and bring you along with me. So this is my site. It is built locally. It's using Astro. So a few things you're going to need. You're going to need GitHub or GitLab. You need a version control to push the code to. And then you also need a Cloudflare account. They do provide free accounts, so sign up for free. All right, here I am in my Cloudflare dashboard. So once you have an account set up, just go to dash.cloudflare. This is what you'll see in your dashboard. I'm going to go to workers and pages, and then I will go to create application. From here, you want to go to the pages tab and connect to Git. This will allow you to deploy the site whenever it's updated in GitHub. You want to connect your GitHub account. We'll install and authorize. I have mine set up using the GitHub mobile app, so I'll have to pause the video and log in. So I'll select the repository that I want. I can choose a branch. Since I only have one main branch, I'll just use main, but you could do like a production or deploy branch. Build settings, they let you choose the framework. So this is convenient. So it'll automatically use the Astro build commands. And let's save and deploy. So this is pretty quick. So the experience here is really similar to Vercel. It's going to run through the build command and let's see if it gives us a URL or something to use. Vercel's definitely laid out a little differently. This reminds me, the layout of this kind of reminds me more of AWS. And it says we're done. So it was really quick. Yeah, and here's the site, Astro. So they use pages.dev as the URL. Interesting. You can set up a custom domain. And then you just configure DNS. So that looks super simple. What else? Settings here. You can rename project. You can add members. So we actually did not need the CLI tool for a static deployment. We just configured it with GitHub. And whenever we push a commit to main, now it's going to redeploy, I believe. Let's try it. So I'm going to make a change and update it. All right. So it's updating automatically with that push. So that's awesome. We got some metrics, which is cool. Oh, you can add environment variables, which is very helpful. You can CPU limit. You can tie in their database stuff right in the dashboard here. So that's super cool. As far as I can tell, this is free for static sites. And it's a great option if you're looking for a hosting provider that's not Vercel or Netlify. It looks like they have a lot of integration with their database stuff and CDNs and stuff like that. So pretty simple. It really was just as simple as Vercel with static hosting. You just log in with your GitHub account. From there, you can add a project. And from there, you can pick a branch to deploy. And there's some continuous integration where it will redeploy when you update the site. So really cool. This is kind of a short video, but I hope this was helpful. Maybe for those people that use Vercel and they're not sure of your other options, Cloudflare, from what I can tell, is a great one. So I hope this was helpful. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video.